Okay, we can start. Okay, welcome to the course, Introduction to Software Architecture Design. My name is Bedir Tekinerdoğan. As you know, before I would like to start, I would like to know your expectations for this course. So why did you select this course? What do you expect from this course? So, can somebody say? So, why this course?
I guess we need a general view of software architecture, and we should learn basic software patterns and their applications. So, that
works. Anybody else? So. Why this course? Let's see.
With the same respect, I choose this course because I'm interested with software engineering.
Software engineering.
I choose software than hardware. So I choose this course.
Okay. Anybody else to add something or? So I should say that software architecture design is indeed one of the most important topics in software engineering. If you want to do software engineering research or take a career in software engineering, actually you should know software architecture design. You have already, before you got the course object-oriented software development, and this is actually a nice follow-up for that course. If you look at the in the world about software architecture design, there's a large community about this topic. It's a specific topic in software engineering. It's educated in many universities. There's many research groups. If you look at the current companies, you have typically now the role of architect. So persons are just assigned as you are the architect or architectural team. There are courses and training for it. Industrial courses, lots of conferences and several journals are dedicated to this topic, dozens of textbooks, and actually also projects are funded by government and industry. Okay, so it's a key topic, and the reason is for this is that software architecture is important. It's one of the key artifacts, key process in software engineering. What about Turkey? If you look at Turkey, of course we start this course in 2002-2003, and also, so that was only that year. We start this also last year, the last semester. And I know of some colleagues at some universities which started to teach this course as well. We had also some workshops that we organized in Turkey, Ulusal Yazılım Mimarisi Conference. This was the first national conference on software architecture design, and the second we hold in Izmir. The third will be probably in Ankara. Before that, we had actually the first workshop in 2005. So also in Turkey, it is just progressing. Okay. Software architecture, if you look at companies, large companies, we just see that also they are aware and they use it, they need it, okay. Software architecture. Different companies apply software architecture, especially if you are a large company, you have to know software architecture. Okay. So what's the required background for this course? Architecture-based software development. We expect that you know object-oriented analysis and design. It's a prerequisite, the course 319, object-oriented design software development. And of course some general knowledge on software design, programming, modeling, etc. So this is actually more higher level course, more advanced course, which requires some background, especially it's also a project-focused course, so to do the project well, you need some computer science background as well. the goals. There are three dimensions here. Learning the key concepts. You have to know, okay, what's the state of the art, what is architecture modeling, what are patterns. You mentioned already some of the architecture views, evaluation. So we have just to teach this course and learn these concepts. Second is an abstract concept, actually. So in order to know it well, you have to experience the process. So therefore, the course is also very project-focused, where you have to do an architecture design project so that you get experience in designing software architecture. We have 7 weeks for that, but that's sufficient. And last but not least, providing insight in the whole topic. Besides of learning the state of the art, you have to know also be aware of the obstacles in software architecture design. What is still an issue which has not been resolved yet, okay? Which could lead to some research assignments later on, I hope, for you. For learning the concepts, we will look at several topics, key topics. We will start with rationale for software architecture. So why do we need software architecture at all? The whole motivation, the relation in the whole software development process. We will look at how to model software architecture modeling, both textual, where we have architecture description languages, and visual, how to model using UML. There's an important topic related to software architecture views. So we don't have just one architecture structure, but multiple structures. So architecture view modeling will be an important issue. Relate to this architectural documentation. How do you document architecture using the views? Of course, the process-related issues, designing an architecture, the process, the methods, the heuristics, well, is another topic. We will focus on a specific approach, a domain-driven approach, and also synthesis-based design approach. It's a method. We will look at patterns, software architectural patterns, and evaluation of software architectures. Okay. So actually modeling the method, and relate to method the patterns, and evaluation. This is the course material. We will use this textbook from Lembas, Paul Clements, and Rick Kazma, Software Architecture in Practice. You should have the second edition. And in addition, we will have some papers, if needed, okay, which we will put on the website. You will have to do a project. It will be a project of group of 2 or 3, where you have to do a problem analysis and domain analysis. So in the project, you will need to follow the whole architecture design method. So in 7 weeks, in week 7, you will need to come up with some architectural design document, okay, which is the result of following some architectural design method, a domain-driven design method, which includes architectural model, architectural views, architectural patterns, and architectural evaluation. The case you have to select yourself. I will explain this later on. Deliverables. There are some assignments, so you have some solutions to assignments, software architecture designs, and PowerPoint presentation. So you will have to. We will have two projects. Actually, this project will be split up in two. We will have midterm and final project. So we will have to present twice. So that's every presentation will take around 20 minutes. And grading we will see later on. The third, so learning the key concepts, experiencing the process, the method. And the third is providing insight. For that, you have to do a critical analysis on existing material. I hope to achieve this goal with discussions during the lectures. most of the insight you will achieve with the lab experience, the project assignments, and finally question and answers. Okay. This is the website will be address will be this. It will be online today. You have to consult this regularly. The prerequisites, as I said, office hours, any free time. So the course organization is like so: lectures, projects, a final exam. Attendance is mandatory. Okay. So we will do some attendance check. This is the course schedule. It's distributed about around 7 weeks. This week we'll do introduction to architecture design, so more rationale, the context, the influence of architecture, architecture in the life cycle. Wednesday we will present the architecture modeling, so architecture modeling in UML, architecture description languages. In week two, we will classify architecture design methods. What are the current architecture design methods? And look at domain analysis and problem analysis, which will be an important process in the method that we will apply. Then we will explain the architecture design methods, look at how to realize this architecture, so how to transition to object-oriented design. Realization here doesn't mean to write any code. Okay, realizing architecture means, in our perspective, detailed design. Okay, so there's no programming or so. Realizing design is detailed design is programming, but we are at a higher abstraction level. Then week four, we will have projects, so you have to present. There will be also project consultancy, where I will take just each group separately and discuss the progress and provide some feedback. So you will get dedicated feedback. Then we will continue with architecture view modeling. Look at what are the views. So based on the stakeholder concerns, we will have different views. We'll explain this, what's the state of the art. Architectural patterns, we will have two sessions for that. And finally, evaluation of architecture. We will look at scenario-based architecture evaluation, architecture trade-off analysis, and if we have time, some other evaluation approaches. Finally, we will conclude with project presentations, discussions, and evaluations. Okay. The schedule can change depending on the discussions and how we progress. Okay. We will have three quiz, short quiz, and one final exam. Okay. Quiz is means for evaluation and for discussing the course topics. So as you saw here, it's around every 2 weeks. So that we just, it will be a closed book, so it's actually easy, small quiz, 30 minutes each, and it will be announced, no pop quiz. I will just announce it, and we will hold it for 30 minutes, and then we will discuss the results of the quiz. Okay? So it's also a means for learning. Attendance, for each course I see this actually, there's a direct correlation with attendance to lectures and the overall grade. Okay, even if you don't check it, it just follows like that, there's a direct correlation. So attendance checks will be taken several times at random. I do it randomly. It's part of grading, 5%. So what's the grading here? It's quiz. We will have three quizzes. Each quiz will be 30%, 10% in total, 30%, project 35%, final exam 30%, attendance 5%. That makes 100, right? Okay. Office hours, I'm in this building, Department of Computer Engineering. My room number, 425. You can call me, mail me, or whatever, just enter if you have any questions. Okay. I don't have specific office hours. Okay, that's for, I think it's more flexible also for you. This is the course, here's the, I need to do something. This is the background, so this this is the required theoretical background, object-oriented analysis and design, other, and of course, like any course actually, it will be more fun if you have active involvement, you have fun, eagerness, to learn, interest and focus, teamwork, and enthusiasm. That will just ease the whole course. And so that brings us to the topic, to we can start. These are the nice buildings in Turkey, which I collected just from the web. They are all related to architecture, nice architecture. So. Any questions about the organization of the course? Okay, it's clear? Okay, then we start. That brings us to the next. So the rationale for software architecture design and the whole context, why do we need software architecture design, where is it located, what does it influence, etc. That will be the topic of this. We will start with a short history about software architecture design, architecture in general. We will look at definitions for software architecture design, which is are stated in the literature, in the textbooks. Look at the motivation for software architecture. Also, we will discuss some common misconceptions. There are quite a lot of misconceptions. We will look at software architecture in life cycle. And finally, influence of software architecture in the project. What is architecture? If you just open up the dictionary, it's from Merriam-Webster's architecture. The art or science of building, specifically the art or practice of designing and building structures, and especially habitable ones. Formation or construction, coherent form or structure. Architectural product or work, a method or style of building, or even the manner in which the components of a computer are, or computer system are organized and integrated. So we have all heard about computer architecture. That's a very general definition. Actually, most of you, I think, have some intuitive meaning about what architecture is, right? If you look at, if you go very in the history, back in the history, one of the earliest architects is considered as Vitruvius, Marcus Vitruvius Pollio, author of the Architectura. He's known as the author of the 10 books on architecture, where he provides some guidelines and practices on designing architectures. This one is interesting. He says a structure must exhibit three qualities: Firmitas, utilitas, venustas, that is, must be strong or durable, useful and beautiful, which is also actually somehow related also software architecture, which are also the qualities that we require for software architecture. Of course, you know Mimar Sinan, the famous Turkish architect, architect of three sultans, large impact on the buildings, especially mosques in Turkey. Also, we have lots of building architectures, buildings in the world, very nice buildings, like the Opera House, even the Egyptian pyramids, the Taj Mahal, etc. Okay? We know, so in the world there are many nice buildings, nice architecture. If we see a building and we say, oh, that's a nice architecture. Okay? Imagine, let's take this example. Okay? The Taj Mahal is built by Mughal Shah Jahan in memory of his wife Mumtaz Mahal. She died and Mughal Shah decided to build such a palace. Okay, quite a romantic guy, but it's a very, very nice building, a huge building actually. Okay, now if you would say, build this palace, okay, we need a palace, and we could very naively say, okay, get some bricks, wood, go find and find many carpenters, masons, and build the palace. Does it go like that? Yes, what do you think? Will they solve the job? What do you think? No. Does it go like that? Why?
They don't know how to build, what to build.
They don't know what to build. Right.
There can be several palaces.
Several, right. And it's also quite huge.
Specifications for that.
Right. So we could find all these carpenters and masons and I say, can we build it? Of course, from intuition we say, of course not. Okay. Even if you hire many of these masons, they cannot build. Well, it requires a different abstraction level, right? You can build with some masons, you can build maybe nice walls, maybe a small house, but not the huge palace like Taj Mahal. Okay? Very large building, which is robust, beautiful. Okay? It's not possible. So this is for intuition, actually. So what's the idea here? We need an architect first. Typically the architect or architect team designs the architecture, the specification, the high level specification, top level specification, and then it is provided to a team, to masons, carpenters, or to the persons who are going to realize the architecture. And that results in the palace. Okay? That's from intuition, right? Of course, we need an architect here. Well, if you look at software development, we know the concepts of lists, arrays, classes, objects, procedures, functions, algorithms, and even a detailed design class, inheritance, etc. We could say these are the nice building blocks. We can define nice programs. These are the building bricks. But these programs cannot be... So if we just focus on these low-level issues, they can be just considered as walls. Okay? It's very hard to develop large-scale software systems. So we are now dealing not with small-scale software systems, but large distributed systems where many people are working on the same problem. It's overly complex. Millions lines of code is required and should be delivered on time and within budget. So actually we say here it's programming or software development in the large. We are not dealing with small problems, but large problems. And typically for these systems, software architecture is a must. Okay? So coding here will not do. You can take this, you can have the best programmers in the world. Okay? But it will not be possible. You will get some nice programs. But to see the overall structure, the gross level structure, you need more than that. Okay? You see, it's just the same analogy. So we are now not building walls, we are building palaces, large systems. And for that we need an architect who defines, like you said, the high level specification. Then you provide the team which knows what to build and how to build. So even more programmers will not do. You could have a rich uncle and you could buy or hire more programmers, but that will not do. Related to this is actually it's the mythical man month for Frederick Brooks. It's one of the classics in software development. Where he says, okay, one of his conclusions here in this book is adding manpower to a late software project will just make it later. In particular, he talks about conceptual integrity, and this can only be achieved by separating architecture from implementation. A single chief architect decides what goes in the system and what stays out. Currently, it's not just a single, but there could be an architectural team. And he says also one of its statements, I came to insist that the teams as small as 4 people choose a manager and a separate architect. Okay? So to have more people in your system, basically if they are just programmers, doesn't help. But you need somebody who has an abstract vision, abstract perspective on the system, which is called the architect, chief architect. So that's the software architecture. So we start with the software architecture design. There's a team, architect or architects, defines the software architecture, which and based on that, it's provided to a team which realizes the software architecture. As I said, realization here means more detailed design, not programming. But it's the earliest artifact. Then we get the large software systems or palaces. I relate to this, so architecture is everywhere. I think everybody has seen the movie The Matrix. This is from The Matrix, I think Reloaded, right? The second part. You know who this guy is? Who's the guy? It's the architect, right? So let me see what he says. I hope you can, oh my God. Hold on. We should have some video now. Right. You cannot hear, okay, but so it's like The Matrix is about a movie where actually robots control the human beings, and they are controlled through software, of course, and the software has some architecture, and this is the architect. That's the fun. So I'm the architect. I created The Matrix. This is just for fun. So architecture is everywhere, especially. So nowadays, software engineering has become very important. Even projects which did not actually foresee that they needed software, they have to deal with software, like embedded systems. And if you are doing software engineering, software development, sooner or later you have to do software architecture, especially if your systems are very complex. The history of software architecture, the history of architecture is quite long actually. History of software architecture started somewhere in the 1960s. History of software or computer science is not that long, started in 1940s. But one of the first persons who indicated the importance of structure in software development is Edgar Dijkstra. He's a Dutch software scientist. He says in 1968, we need the correct arrangement of the structure of software systems before simple programming. And in particular, he introduced the notion of layered structure, which you might know maybe. Programs where he says, okay, programs should be grouped into layers, and programs in one layer can only communicate with programs in adjoining layers. Okay, so you have a huge program. What he says is you have to structure this program into layers, okay, kind of grouping, and he puts some constraints on these layers. So program, the layers can only neighboring layers can communicate with each other. Why? To support development and support maintenance. Okay. So quality of the software. This was he focused mainly on structure of programming. So this is described in the structure of the multi-programming system in communications of the ACM from 1968. You could read it, so if you have time. Another person is Dave Parnas. Besides of structure, he talks about selected criteria for defining this structure. And he talks about so-called design principles. So to define the right decomposition, we have to define the principles. He introduced several design principles, like information hiding modules, where he said, identify design decisions that are likely to change, and isolate these in separate modules, which led also to the principle of separation of concerns, an important principle. Another was hierarchical structures, okay, stepwise refinements, 1974, and 75 he talks about program families, which is more related to reuse. Okay. So if you look at the history, in the history of computer science, 1940, the first computers, we had very simple algorithmic programming. Okay. Later on, we got more data-intensive applications, distributed systems, and now we have just talking about so-called mega programs. So software has changed both in nature and also in size and complexity. And it is now actually what we say is become impossible to develop these systems without the software architecture. Okay? The software architecture. So these are the problems that we have seen. We look at the history, simple programs, till now we are dealing with mega programs. Relate to that, actually, the solution domain has also evolved. So we had programming any which way, just program as you do. Programming in the small, like structured programming languages. Programming in the large, where it was supported by case tools, object-oriented design. And now programming in the world. You could try to solve this with these problems, large problems, with these solution techniques, but of course that's not wise. Okay? To solve large complex software problems, you have to also address the right solution techniques. And one of the key techniques is software architecture design. This is a short summary of the structured concept in software. In 1960s, we had structured programming. Soon after that, design methods followed with structured design, 1970s. 1980s was the period of modular programming languages, in particular object-oriented design. 1990s started the first papers publications on software architecture design, so towards software architecture design. And 2000s is actually now a common practice, more or less common practice. Okay. And what we see is just actually specialization of the concepts, specialization of modeling techniques, specialization of methods, of architectural views, introduction of new patterns, development of new evaluation techniques. But the idea, the need for software architecture, the necessity is just known. And it so you have now architectural teams in companies. Right? Any questions so far? This was just a short introduction for intuition, basically, and how things have developed. Okay? So let's look at definitions. Definition for software architecture. This was definition of the architecture concept in text of physical architecture, the art or science of building, design building structures, etc. Actually, we know that architecture is everywhere. In any artifact, take any artifact, and you have a, you can say we have an architecture of it. Okay? We have a computer architecture, building architecture, plane architecture, bridge architecture, etc. Before we start with the discussions, definition on software architecture, how would you define software architecture? Okay, so you can take just, if you can have short discussion with two persons and try to define, write down on paper what software architecture is, definition. Based on the, okay, intuitive introduction. Okay, just two minutes, if you can just write down, just force your brains. What would be your definition of software architecture? You can discuss aloud and so on then. Software architecture is okay. So let's write these down. I want to write it down. Definition one. What's your definition?
Software architecture is a method of distribution of projects.
Distribution of projects
into adjoint layers and a general view. Total software development process. And the software system.
And the software system. There are some typos, but okay, doesn't matter. Adjoint. This definition? Okay. Other definitions? What's your definition? And making the architectural. But this is recursive definition. In any case. So what is software architecture then? But you folks, you are basically focused on project management, right? Okay. Any definition is fine for now. Okay. What's definition? Directly, sorry, I didn't get it. Directly, what the?
Directly the programming workforce for solving the real world problem.
For solving a real world problem. No typos. What else? Definition? One more definition. You have definition? No definition. You have definition?
How you...
Anything is fine. Yeah.
In a particular solution, it's how you... The conceptual design of a particular problem.
That's also nice. Maybe one more.
Designing small pieces
and
separate layers that can work in harmony and construct holes.
Designing small pieces.
Small pieces and separate layers that can work in harmony and construct holes.
Right? So these are our definitions. No need to laugh, so. Method of distribution of projects into adjoint layers and the general view of total software development process and software system. Okay, how to make a software projects. How to make a software project. Directing programming force for real world problem. Still a type of conceptual design of a particular problem. Designing small pieces and separate layers that can work in harmony and that can be consistent. Good. So this is your intuition. I see what I observe here is there's some notion of layering. So you have, I think, seen some layered architectures. And so you say, so architecture definition is a layered system, right? There's also about project architecture helps to manage projects, okay. Even if the first part is okay. Distribution of projects at joint layers, etc. Okay, conceptual design, which is also interesting, which is different from the other definitions, etc. Okay. Now let's look at the state of the art. What the in the textbooks? This is from Grady Booch, one of the earliest. It's actually object-oriented analysis and design book, but it talks also about software architecture design. Provides a definition about that. What does it say? The logical and physical structure of a system, forced by all the strategic and tactical design decisions applied during development. So it's a bit more general. So what does it say? It looks at the, it is a high level structure of a system directed by strategic tactical design decisions during development. Okay, one definition. This is from Perry and Wolf, which that go further. It's also in 92. We distinguish three different classes of architectural elements. Processing elements, which are data elements, processing elements, data elements, and connection elements. And they continue. The processing elements are those components that supply transformation on data. Data elements are those that contain the information that is used and transformed. And connecting elements are the glue that holds the different pieces of the architecture. So they provide a more specialization of the architectural elements. They say architecture consists of three type of elements: processing elements, data, and connection. And they explain it. Consider the types of architecture components and relations. Garland and Shaw again, this further specialization where they talk about gross organization and global control structure. This notion has actually led to the so-called architectural styles. From Perry, Garland and Perry, the structure of the components of a program, their interrelationships and principles and guidelines governing their design and evolution over time. This is what is important here is the architecture cross-level structure, but also needs to include the principles and guidelines for that. Okay, it's explicit in the definition. This is from IEEE, it's still valid, also cited a lot. Software architecture is the fundamental organization of a system, cross-level structure, embodied in its components, consisting of components, their relationships to each other and the environment, and the principles governing its design and evolution. Cross-level structure consisting of components, connectors, plus the principles. Okay. This is one of the stable definitions, I should say. And another one, which is quite cited a lot, and it's from Lambas, Clemens, Kazman, also from your textbook. The software architecture of a program or computing system is the structure or structures of the system, which comprise software components, the externally visible properties of those components, and the relationships among them. At least it's again the structure, cross-level structure, but what we see here is also they focus on more than one structure. They explicitly define that an architecture includes more than one structure. Okay. Why did they do that? Because to indicate that architecture has multiple views. We will also address this topic later on. And the component, we are not interested in internal details, but only the externally visible properties of those components. Okay. So these are the definitions, and actually the last two definitions are quite stable and used a lot from IEEE or from your textbook. What we can see is it has evolved. Also, the definition of software architecture has evolved together with technical developments. There are different definitions, but we see a common agreement on architecture includes cross-level structure, includes components and connectors among these components. Okay. Some also say we need to include design principles. We have more than one structure, etc. But in general, this is the common part. Okay. So if we look back at your definitions, we go very quick. Some issues are related, others not, but that's fine. Okay. So it's not per definition layered. Okay. It helps to support the project. It helps to guide the programming, etc. It is somehow conceptual design at the gross level structure. Okay. So there are also some truth here, of course. Okay, that's nice. Any questions about definitions? Okay, let's break for 10 minutes.